Why do we impute data for the Consumer Price Index? Each month, BLS collects around 100,000 prices for various items and services to measure price change. Sometimes we cannot collect the price of the item we're trying to measure because there aren't any items available on the shelf for purchase. BLS ran into this frequently in the early days of the COVID-19 pandemic, when products like toilet paper and cleaning products were rapidly selling out and stores couldn't replenish them. When we have missing data, we have used for decades a common statistical method called imputation to fill in the blanks. For example, let's say we're trying to collect the price of milk in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, but an outlet the data collector visited was all out of milk. The CPI uses three imputation methods. The first method is called home cell or same cell imputation. This method takes the price change from the same geographic area and product or service category and applies that price change to calculate the missing price. So if our data collector could not collect the price of milk from store A in Allegheny County, Pennsylvania, we would use the average price change for milk collected from other stores in the Pittsburgh area. This is the preferred method because we are reasonably certain the price changes across the same geography for the same item are similar. The next type of imputation is called different cell imputation. This method uses the price for the same product or service, but from a different geographic area. In our example, we did not have a price for milk in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, so we used the average price change for milk from the Middle Atlantic geographic area. This type of imputation keeps the product or service similar, though the geography is broader. The final imputation method is called carry forward. This takes the last collected price for the product or service and carries it forward to the next month. For example, if we could not collect the price of milk across the country, the price of milk at store A in Pittsburgh in the prior month would also be used for the current month. This option is rarely used because our goal is to measure price change, and the carry forward method assumes the price did not change. BLS uses imputation to help capture price change when we cannot collect the actual price of the sampled product or service. It's important to remember that imputation is not just a guess. It uses the power of the data we have already collected to fill in missing data. To learn more about imputation and to see what types of imputation are being used each month in the CPI, check out the imputation page on BLS.gov.